Several days, although you never go to sleep, but it wasn't like, I don't know, I just messed up. Suddenly I couldn't play as efficient anymore because I was just thinking about how you were gonna seal it, and in the end I got used to it, so yeah. So basically here, at this point you can see there's like the coffee drink and a mint tea drink, I guess, but you can only make one of them and then you have to wait, you have to pick it up, and well, I don't even know if it makes sense to show it to you. Ah, there is an item delivered. Ah, this is good. So now I actually bought a second oven, and here you can see you can buy stuff. Oh, I don't have enough money. Well, you can buy stuff, and if you buy stuff, things become more efficient or faster, or for example, now I immediately put in two of those pies, even though I don't know what will be ordered, just so that there is something going on. So I can give something to my assistant over there who is good at the strawberries, I guess. So now everybody needs the green drink, the mint drink, so I'm gonna make a lot of those. And then in every game, or like every level, there is a different objective. Sometimes it is a certain number of customers, sometimes it is a certain number of money that you have to make, and sometimes there's like edit goals. For example, no customer can leave because you're just too slow, but that actually never happens. At least I haven't had that happen to me yet. Or you cannot let anything burn. If you wait something, you know, something is in the oven and you wait for too long, it will get burned. And normally you can just throw it out and you have to make another one, of course, so it will slow you down a little bit, but it's not like a game over situation. But sometimes it is. And there's also, yeah, there's this trash can in the corner, the right-handed corner next to this sink. And I'm actually seeing that sink now for the first time. It's funny, if you're just so concentrated on the game itself, you don't look at the other things that don't play a role. Kind of like, do you know those videos of, what is it, like, basketball players, I guess, and then there is some sort of animal in between, a panda, I don't know, something, and then they ask, did you see the beer? Is it a beer? I don't know, and people are like, how much? Because, oh yeah, they I'm not making any sense with this story. People got the assignment to count, I don't know, the number of passes, or, you know, to count something, and if they're doing that, then they're not paying attention to anything else. So yeah, let's see. Are I gonna play again? Yes. Ah, now it is not throw out any dishes. So, but two pies in the oven. Ah, one person needs a pie, croissant, alright. Croissant in blue and green. And there's also an upgrade that you can change the drink station, the coffee station, into two separate places, so that you can actually make a coffee and a mint drink thingy at the same time, and that's really convenient because then you can always just have them standing there full. They won't get cold, which is kind of strange, but that's just how the game works. So as soon as you need one of them, you can just grab them because they'll be there, and then you immediately start to make another one. So there's always one of them, and that way, by the way, all these scooter sounds, they're in the game, you know that, right? There's, you can see there's a bike if you look out of the window in a tree, so there's scooters over there. Yeah. Okay. Then, let's see, another pie. It's kind of strange because it looks like the assistant is cutting the pie itself in several little pieces, which clearly is not what is happening, because he's adding stuff. So that actually makes no sense. Oh yeah, is this where I failed the level completely? This is a level where I couldn't throw something in the trash, and I did. I forgot about it. option to continue, because this was actually the very first time in the game that I ever messed up a level. And then I could for free renew, because the game, you know, it's sort of like a tutorial in the beginning, and the game shows you what you can do. So I passed anyway, even though I messed up. How about that? So now there is some sort of storyline again. I don't know, I didn't even pay attention to this. And there will be rewards, 10 of those red thingies. That's good. They are convenient to have. Another episode 5. What's this, victory or bust? Alright, alright, alright. Good news. Okay, let's go to the store. Banknotes. Ah, yeah, so now she's getting it. She's actually used to having food there, like, indefinitely. Is that a word? Like, not like just a little bit, and that she has to wait, but just there, like, usually all the time. And she's, like, skinny, so that's okay. She can handle it somehow. Many cats can't, but, Mikey, you'll get food soon. See, I'm busy doing another video. I kind of have to practice doing these gaming YouTube stuff. I was actually inspired by Jubilee Whisper. She has all these beautiful games that she's playing, and I don't even want to watch some of them because the graphics already look so beautiful. And I'm like, I want to buy this game, but I can't yet. But I mean, don't feel bad for me. It's a good motivation to pay off my student loans extremely fast. Which I'm doing, so that's good. At the end of this year, I'll be finished with everything, so that's good. And I am actually creating The Sims videos with Jubilee Whispers. I hope we'll be doing one of those again soon. I'll have to send her an email and I will. Life is kind of busy, but I'm really looking forward to that one, so. Yeah, but yeah, she's just so good. Counter, I should say, they see that order that you're making, and This is what it is.